Hello YouTube viewers, welcome to my show Rocket Monday. In today's episode, we're going to take a look at Space Launch System by NASA or SLS. So what it is, it's a super heavy lift rocket. All you have to understand about that, it simply means it's going to put more than 50 ton. These are some examples like Long March 9 from China. Then we have New Glenn from Blue Origin. We have BFR from SpaceX. We have Saturn V from NASA. So this is the classification of rocket. Minimum of 50 tons. Then this is designed from day one to replace Space Shuttle. Now Space Shuttle is already retired, so right now there is a vacuum. That's why American astronauts go to Russia, then to International Space Station. America as of now have no replacement. This replacement is behind schedules basically. And it was designed so it can exceed Space Shuttle capabilities. Space Shuttle, while what it did what it's supposed to do, was not designed to go any higher than low Earth orbit. Basically, you could not have used Space Shuttle to go to Moon. This can do that. And then the Space Shuttle part, as in like what's gonna carry the crew in this system, is Orion. Orion is completely independent from SLS. Do not confuse both of them. Then we come to design and development aspect of it. Basically, they took everything they learned from Saturn V, which was their big heavy lift rocket and was very safe, very successful, and Space Shuttle. While not safe, nor successful, nor cheap, but it did had some good advantages. So they took the learning from both of them and combined them. And they had to make sure that this time their human rated system have what's called launch abort capability. As many of you know, this Saturn V has a very pencil like thing that on top, that is a rocket engine that is there in case lower stages to blow up. They're just gonna fire that and take the astronauts away with them, like the whole crew module will be taken apart, so that way they can ensure that in case of a rocket explosion they will not lose the astronauts. And the design from day one, it's not like Saturn V. Saturn V was a like complete structure. Like they built the Saturn V, they did a little bit of refinement here and there, but they did not change the engines. They did not change the whole system, like second stage or third stage. In this, they are taking a bit more flexible approach. You can say it's more like SpaceX Falcon 9 series, where they kept improving. So they also call it block system, where you have SLS block one, which will take roughly 90 tons. Then you have block one, B crew, which can take a bit more, or it would be specifically designed to take crew. So things like that they are doing to improve the design. So first is supposed to carry roughly 90 ton to low Earth orbit, and then the later versions can take upwards of 150 tons. So they are gonna improve the design once it was built. So, and it's supposed to cost less than Space Shuttle, because Space Shuttle failed miserably on the cost front. They want to make sure they don't repeat the same mistake. So how does it actually work? Now, I told you, like Space Shuttle, while did not create many good things, it did give us one of the best engines. Now, of course, you can say this engine is better than this engine, but things stand, as I talk to you, this engine is very powerful, very efficient, and it's a closed cycle. Basically, it's not like a SpaceX engine where the exhaust is just, you know, gas generator exhaust is just let out. It goes inside that. And because it's using hydrogen, it has higher specific impulse, which means if you fire these engines for a given amount of time, the higher top speed you will gain because of this. This is why Atlas series of rockets are still in use. Even though SpaceX can launch heavier and cheaper, they does not have enough top speed. Scott Manley did a very interesting video about that, and I urge you to watch it. So these engines are quite well, and even the engine nozzle is designed in such a way that it can work from very low, as in like sea level, to very high, as in to flat out space. So this was kind of unique. So suffice to say, this is a very good system. The engine name is RS-25, or you can search for it by typing SSME, Space Shuttle Main Engine. Then you have to understand, this is using hydrogen and liquid oxygen. So we know that. That's why you see the orange color. This is basically Space Shuttle fuel tank. That is what they took from Space Shuttle, the engine, the fuel. Then you have to understand the boosters, because as I mentioned in my video, that if you use hydrogen, you get a lot of top speed, but consequence of that is you do not have what's called enough Newton. Basically, you do not have enough thrust to get off the ground. Could they have solved this? Yes, they could have done, made the first stage much more fatter. And then instead of putting four engines, they could have put fifth engine, and that way they could go off the ground. Now, right now they can still do it. They can still remove the solid boosters and still fire the four engines. It's gonna go to space. It's just the payload capacity will go down. For that reason, we use solid rocket booster. The solid rocket booster used here is exactly the same design, architecture, of course more refined, more polished, from space shuttle era. Now, space shuttle era boosters were reusable. Basically, once it was jettisoned from space shuttle, it came back using parachutes and it was recovered, refurbished and reused. In this scenario, it's use and throw. And instead of using four segmented, basically there were four segmented joined by O-rings, they're gonna use what's called five segment, just one more segment, and they're designing it to be more refined. So this is how it actually works. So be mindful, they can remove SRBs, but problem would be like it will not have enough launch capacity. Like it may come down to as low as 20 tons. So politics aspect of it, as I have made a lot of videos about criticizing NASA, and you can check my video why NASA sucks. It's like my biggest problem with NASA is the introduction of politics into it. And many people are saying that because of the fact that it's using what's called space shuttle components, only the manufacturers that have built space shuttle component can compete in this race. This mandate, it's called de facto non-competitive. Basically, you can't compete with RS-25 if the requirement is like build RS-25. You can't compete against this. This was already mass produced. Not mass produced, not like millions of pieces, but many RS engine, like for one or two rockets, they flat out don't even need to build new engines. They're gonna refine these engines. So as I talk to you, this created a scenario where even though NASA can say, oh, it's open, you built a system, I'm gonna buy it, because they created a mandate where they had to use space shuttle component, they are stuck. And the fact SRBs are used, now many of you know, there was a clone of space shuttle which was built by USSR, Soviet Union basically, and they also had what we call side boosters. However, their boosters were liquid. Now you might ask why they are using solid boosters when it explodes, and it did explode. It did kill 7 astronauts. The reason for that is SRBs are the core component of ICBM. Now US Army wanted to test out ICBM technology, but they cannot test it without, you know, alerting the whole world that they are testing it. Now they went to NASA and they're like, use SRB, that way we get more advanced ICBMs. So this was a collaboration between government, and it's kind of necessary and important, because as many of you know, space is space was built for primary function to kill each other, ICBMs. So this, many people are also calling it what's called Senate launch system, because Senate decided just because you have to use this old system, you are stuck. It's not like engineers sat down and like, okay, these engines are good, can we make it better? No, like just use this SRB. Like Senate decided, not engineers, not technicians, Senate decided. And it's already behind schedule, it's NASA thing obviously, and it's already over budget. Now of course it's not as over budget as what we call James Webb Space Telescope, but this is going over budget, and early estimates are in that under no circumstances is gonna meet its price target. Basically the price tag they're selling, they might meet it over 2-3 generations, because they have learned a lot from space shuttle, but it will not be cheap. Now there are many criticism of space shuttle, space launch system, and many people are saying we should cancel it. The primary reason for that is it's not reusable, it's use and throw. Heck, even the SRB which was built to be refurbished, not reused, refurbished, as in they're gonna take the casing, remove the paint, rebuild it. It costed more than the new rocket boosters, that's why they're flat out throwing it away in this time. Is that when you have other companies, two companies as I talk to you already have rocket that can send payload to orbit, including this one. Of course the payload size will be small, but it can send payload to orbit, and this one is already done successful 20 plus landings, and it can put upwards of 10 to 20 tons in low Earth orbit. So suffice to say, not you making a system that is reusable inherently means that it's a use and throw system. Inherently means super expensive engines that you're gonna build is gonna be use and throw. Inherently that means the cost will be too high. That is the primary reason so many people wants to cancel this, that when they built the SLS, they were not thinking ahead. They basically went back to Saturn V and they just refined the design of Saturn V. And they did not even refine it properly. If they had refined it properly, they would have used 5 engines rather than 4 engines and flat out discarded solid boosters. Because SRBs, while they are good, while they are relatively safe, it inherently means you have extra components in your system, which inherently means you're gonna be having more expenses than you need to. So all things considered, there is some valid criticism of that. And not to mention this, I want to make sure you guys understand, neither this nor BFR can go to Mars and come back. The reason for that is that if they went to the Mars, if they landed it, there is no way they can get off Mars. BFR can do from Earth, but from Earth to Moon, it can do that. Like, it can go there without refueling in orbit, it can go there, land, come back. It has enough fuel to do that. However, this SLS cannot do that simply because it does not have what's called a lunar ascent module. Basically, it cannot land on Moon. It is solely built for basically building deep space gateway, which my video you can check out there. And all things you have to understand about that is, the only reason why people are calling it Mars rocket is that they are gonna send Orion capsule, plus there is a system which we calling ion propulsion system, which they're gonna use to send to Mars. Basically, it's not a complete system, it's not as complete as BFR. To be true, BFR is also not complete. If it does not make fuel on the surface of Mars, it cannot come back. So suffice to say, there is a lot of fair criticism about this rocket system. I hope you liked my video and learned from it. In that case, please leave a like. And if you didn't, no worry about it, dislike it. And I would urge you to comment what you want to see in my next episode. And I would say, please subscribe. I need 1,000 subscribers for monetization. Please, you can help me out.